Obviously, the Iranian situation is big in the news, but it isn't big news in the markets. 187, we closed Thursday after the news, but right before the news came out, 157 in a two-year. So down three more basis points in twos, down eight more in tens. Why is the market nonplussed by what many in the newspapers are calling a very wild hornet's nest?
Rick, we've had this hornet's nest year in, year out. It shows up every couple of years with problems in the Middle East. The market is really focusing on it for a very short time. But you know, the reality is most people don't realize that 10 years opened up early Thursday morning at 194 and moved all the way down to 175, 176, 179, 180 right now. I think the big surprise this year is going to be higher rates and a steeper curve. The same people that told us in 2018 that 2019 was going to have the 10-year at 3% are the same people that are telling us this year it's going to be 180. So I think the big surprise is going to be much higher yields. We see 10 years maybe going to 220 with twos, tens going, breaking the 35 that they were at in late December to maybe out to 70. So we're looking for a much higher yield, but it's not going to happen today. We got to get through this Middle Eastern turmoil, or as you said, hornet's nest.
Yes, and really, you've nailed it. That we are so compressed in yields across the globe, whether some countries have negative yields, that the notion of being able to push yields much lower is difficult, even with a geopolitical situation, which leads me to the next big obstacle: central banks, big balance sheets. You know, Andy, we're getting close to levels we haven't seen that were the top of the iceberg, $4.5 trillion. We're getting closer and closer on the U.S. balance sheets. Your final thoughts as to how we are going to see these central banks deal with any surprise slowness in 2020?
Rick, you hit it right on the point. Since September, the Fed has been growing their balance sheet at an annualized 30% rate. That can't continue. The repo situation really should have been handled differently, but the way they handled it was to increase the balance sheet. That will end sometime in the first quarter, and we think that things are going to get a lot hairier then, including credit spreads widening, higher interest rates, steeper yield curve, but not an equity correction right away, but that will happen.